Hello everyone, welcome to AptiPlus Academy for Civil Services. This is a video on daily news and editorial analysis, which I'll be covering from the Hindu and Indian Express. So the most important news and editorial would be discussed in this session. Let's get started with the topic first. Today is 12th of July. The first topic is Uttar Pradesh launches new population policy by 2025-2030, right? Second, new IT rules will be empowering and protect users. Third, railway to focus on pediatrics facilities. Second last, that is proposed Limuru Elephant Reserve in Chhattisgarh. And the last is tapping the potential of youth. So this is an editorial, and this Limuru Tiger Elephant Reserve is basically from the explained section of the Indian Express. Apart from this, there would be some MCQs question at the end of the session. These questions would be based on current affairs to help you in the upcoming prelims examination. And those of you who are new to our channel, do not forget to subscribe AptiPlus Academy for Civil Services on YouTube. If you like this video, do not forget to give a thumbs up. We'll start a session with the first news, that is Uttar Pradesh launches new population policy 2021-2030. What are the relevant point that you need to understand, right? And any of you who are preparing either for the Uttar Pradesh Public Service Commission for the state PCS, these type of questions become very relevant. So this is important for your General Studies paper 2, functions and responsibility of union and states. So what is the detail of this news? Basically what has happened? Now let's understand the detail of this news. Uttar Pradesh government ne recently state population policy 21-2030 ke liye release kiya hai. And this was launched on the occasion of World Population Day. So 11th of July is celebrated as World Population Day. Bill ki kuch important emphasis hai. First is to need to control, stabilize the population of state for the promotion of sustainable development for more equitable distribution, right? What happened? When you have large number of population, so distribution share hai, wo kam ho jati hai, right? So the share is being decreased if there is a large number of population. So government ne kaha hai ki jab two child policy ko government promote kar rahi hai, so that definitely mean to help the masses and the citizen of the particular state. State ki total fertility rate ki baat kare, that as of now, the total fertility rate of the state is 2.7%, right? This number is important. And the draft provision hai, policy ki, population policy ki, that constitutes state population fund to implement the population control bill, and this will come into effect once the bill is finally approved or the policy is finally on the implementation part. Now let's understand some detail. This infographic is already there in the Hindi newspaper. So we'll understand what government actually is trying to do. So they would be implementing this on a time-bound manner, or policy ke kuch measures aim hai. First is to decrease the total fertility rate, right? As I've told you, the current fertility rate is 2.7. So you can see here 2.7 is the current fertility rate. So government wanted to reduce by 2.1 by 2026 and 1.7% by 2030. So this is the aim in terms of the total or fertility rate. Now coming to the modern contraceptives prevalence rate ki agar baat kare, so this rate is as of now is 31.7%, and what government is trying that they will increase it to 45% by 2026 and 52% by 2030. So these numbers are important. Now increase in male contraceptive uses, presently it is 10.8%, and government would increase it to 15.1% by 2026. Now government also want to decrease the MMR, that is maternal mortality rate. So this is being calculated per death by lakhs, right? Kitni death hui hai har lakh birth pe. So 197 hai abhi, and isko reduce karne ki koshish ki ja rahi hai, 150 and 98 by 2030, right? Decrease in infant mortality rate, jo IMR hoti hai, उसमें भी 1000 के हिसाब से कैलकुलेट की जाती है कि हर 1000 बच्चे में कितने बच्चे की डेथ हो रही है. सो दिस इज 43 एज ऑफ नाउ. द गवर्नमेंट वांट टू रिड्यूस इस टू 32. इसको रिड्यूस करनी है 32 द बाय 2026 एंड 22 बाय 2030, राइट. एंड द लास्ट इज डिक्रीज अंडर 5 मोर्टेलिटी रेट. सो इसको बढ़ा करके 47 से 35 एंड अगेन बाय 25. सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट इंक्रीज एंड डिक्रीज रेशियो दैट इज ऑलरेडी देयर इन द न्यूज़पेपर. आप इस चीज को समझ ले कहाँ पे चीज़ों को इंक्रीज करने की टारगेट रखी है गवर्नमेंट ने और किस चीज़ को डिक्रीज करने के लिए रखी है, राइट. सो अगेन एन इम्पॉर्टेंट इनिशिएटिव, द मोस्ट क्रिटिकल पार्ट इज द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ दिस पॉलिसी. नाउ सम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ द फैसिलिटीज गवर्नमेंट ने कहा है, गवर्नमेंट इज बेसिकली ट्राइंग टू प्रमोट टू चाइल्ड पॉलिसी, राइट. सो टू चाइल्ड पॉलिसी जो पेरेंट्स या जो इंडिविजुअल नहीं रखेंगे उनके लिए कुछ सर्विसेज को डिबार्ट किया जाएगा. एंड दे सेड दैट द पीपल विल नॉट बी अलाउड टू कंटेस्ट पोल, राइट, प्रिवेंटिंग देम फ्रॉम अप्लाइंग और गेटिंग प्रमोशन इन द गवर्नमेंट जॉब्स एंड इवन रिसीविंग द गवर्नमेंट सब्सिडी. सो गवर्नमेंट हैज़ कैटेगोरिकली सेड दैट दोज हु विल नॉट बी कंप्लाइंग विद द टू चाइल्ड पॉलिसी वुड बी डिबार्ड फ्रॉम दीज फैसिलिटीज. Now coming to the rationale behind this policy, जो स्टेट गवर्नमेंट है उसकी क्या rationale है. So government ने कहा that the rising population was a root problem for major prevailing inequality in the society. Suppose government has a share of like 100 kg rice, right? They want to distribute on X number of population. And if there is only 10 people, the equal amount that would be distributed would be 10 kgs, right? So as the population increases, the share that is being distributed to the people is drastically decreasing. So, एक inequality को खत्म करने के लिए population control करने के लिए government ने एक rationale बताई है. Second, increasing population can be an obstacle to development. To some extent, these are true point and the true rationale which government quoted. The third is new policy was be drafted keeping in mind with the all section of society. एक holistic development के लिए we need a control in the population, right? And if there is no gap between the birth of two child, it will naturally affect the nutrition. So government ne kaha ki agar suppose what medical science recommended between one child and second child, there should be a gap of 3 to 4 years minimum, right? A minimum of 3 to 4 years is required so that the mother and the child can grow comprehensively and the nutrition level should be also complete. So this is what the recommendations of the government is. Now the new IT rules are willing to empower and protect the users. So the news is important for Gender Studies paper 2, government policies and intervention for the development of various sectors. And as we know, Ashnavi Vaishnav is a new IT and communication minister. So the portfolio has changed and the prime minister has increased his cabinet. So the new minister is trying to add some actions that help in the particular rule that was already prevailing, right? So the Information Technology and Communication Ministry has said that the new information technology rules would empower and protect the user, right? Basically, there was a lot of debate that was coming from the new IT rule, and possibly you can have a mains question in this particular topic. So make sure you're thorough with the concepts. Now, new IT rule ki baat kare, the ministry has said this would ensure a safe and more responsible social media ecosystem in the country, right? I have already discussed the new IT rules with you in detail in the fortnight current affairs as well as in the daily news analysis. If you have not watched that video, do check it out in the playlist section. Now, what is the mandate of new IT rule, right? So, kuch important mandates ki baat kare. So, the new IT rule come into effect on May 25th. और इसकी मैंडेट की बात करें तो यहाँ पे एक ग्रीवांसेस रेडिसल मैकेनिज्म ऑफिसर्स को रिक्रूट करने की बात की गई है. सारे जितने भी इंपॉर्टेंट प्लेटफॉर्म इंडिया में ऑपरेट कर रहे हैं सोशल मीडिया प्लेटफॉर्म्स, दीज गाइडलाइन एम्पावर एंड प्रोटेक्ट द यूजर एंड वुड इंश्योर अ रिस्पॉन्सिबल सोशल मीडिया इकोसिस्टम इन द कंट्री. बात की गई है ऑल द सिग्निफिकेंट सोशल मीडिया कंपनीज जिसके यूजर 50 लाख से ऊपर हैं उनको एक ग्रीवांस ऑफिसर अपॉइंट करनी होगी एंड दे हैव टू डील विद द कंप्लेन and the contact details of the officer should be made to the public domain, that should be available in the public domain. Now the big social media companies are mandated to appoint chief compliance officer. They would be also appointing the CCO apart from the grievances officer, or unke jo nodal person honge and the resident grievance officer should be available so that they can properly give a resolutions to the customer's problem. And all officers appointed should be a resident of India. So an NRI cannot be even appointed and only the resident of India would be appointed as an officer, either of the grievances or the chief compliance officers. Now, some regulation, just to give you a brief, I have already discussed in detail, social media, digital media की बात करें, identification of first originator की बात की गई है, appointment of grievance officers, file monthly compliances reports. For digital media, there is a free council, follow up press council, जो cable network regulation act, उसको follow करनी होगी, regulation bodies to overseas and other the code, और ministry of INB इसको regulate करेगी. OTT platform के लिए self classified content होगी based on age, parental locks on the content and age verification mechanism for the adult content. So these are some of the broad areas upon which the new IT rule were framed. Now some objections that were raised by the companies, अगर बात करें WhatsApp की, which is being owned by the Facebook, they have challenged the new IT rule in the High Court and even in the Supreme Court. But Delhi High Court has categorically said that basically you cannot compel an individual or your customers to update and share their privacy, right? So this is against the violation of right to privacy. So as of now, मैंने आपको Saturday का भी news में बताया था, WhatsApp ने कहा है, they would not ask customer to update the privacy policy, right? So it has been stopped or it has been delayed till the further notification. And WhatsApp has alleged कि जो requirement होती है intermediaries की identifiable first originator के लिए, in India upon the government code would puts end-to-end inscription at risk, right? So WhatsApp की अपनी stake है कि end-to-end inscription इससे खतरा हो सकता है इसको. And some media houses has also challenged the new IT rules as it is a sub judice, right? Still in the court. Now coming to the other news, that is railway to focus on pediatrics facility. This is important for your general studies paper 2, issues related to development and management of health. So what is the preparation of the future COVID wave? Ministry of Railway has called for a full preparedness to ensure testing, ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा testing हो, track की जाए अगर किस तरह के cases हैं, we need to isolate and track them, treating the patients and gradually lifting the lockdown in many states, right? As we know that Railway Ministry are also running with the huge losses because of less number of train operating in India. So the decision has been taken amid a strong apprehension of the future course of COVID-19 waves which could be there. We possibly pray that there does not be any COVID wave, right? Already till second wave, there has been a lot of devastation we have seen in the economy and as in the overall, the general people ki baat kare, wahan pe bhi kafi zyada losses hui hai. So definitely we need to prepare for the third wave so that if any mishappening happen, we could counter it. प्रिपेडनेस की गाइडलाइन दी गई है मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ रेलवेज ने, उन्होंने कहा है कि जो चीफ मेडिकल डायरेक्टर्स होंगे हर जोनल रेलवेज में, दे हैव टू कंप्लाई एंड दे हैव टू इंश्योर दैट अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ एडिक्वेट इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर स्पेशली फॉर द पेडियाट्रिक्स पेशेंट्स, राइट? जो बच्चे हैं, जो एक स्पेसिफिकली डिपार्टमेंट होती है मेडिकल साइंस में पेडियाट्रिक्स, जो बच्चे के लेकर के उसको उसके बारे में बताती है, सो एक पेडियाट्रिक्स पेशेंट्स के लिए अलग से इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलप की जाए. And immediate upon change in the demographic profile of the patients or increase in the number of the infection. If the number of the patient increase, we have to categorize them as per the age. And Railway ने ये भी कहा है कि जो transport of million passengers every day हो रही है, that would enforce COVID appropriate behavior. जो SOP है, standard operating procedures, उसको follow करने की ज़रूरत है. And they need to have a mass vaccination both for the employees and the beneficiaries. कुछ वनरेबल ग्रुप हैं, बेसिकली द मोस्ट वनरेबल ग्रुप नीड टू बी वैक्सीनेटेड, पर्टिकुलरली जो 18 से कम की एज ग्रुप है. वी नो एज ऑफ नाउ द वैक्सीन इज नॉट अवेलेबल, सप्लाई इज डूइंग ट्रायल, बट उसके ऊपर 18 प्लस के जितने भी लोग हैं, दे शुड बी गिवन वैक्सीनेशन एट द अर्लीस्ट. एंड मोस्ट रेलवे हॉस्पिटल हैज़ बिन प्रोवाइडेड सफिशियंट फैसिलिटी टू सप्लाई ऑक्सीजन इफ देर इज अ डिमांड ऑफ ऑक्सीजन अराइजिंग, सो दे आर एनरेजिंग द सिलेंडर्स एंड कंसेंट्रेटर्स. एंड ऑल द जनरल मैनेजर ऑफ द जोनल रेलवे, उनको बताया गया है कि आपको सारी बेनिफिशरीज को वैक्सीनेट करना है, इंक्लूडिंग द पोर्टर्स, कॉन्ट्रैक्टर्स एंड अदर पीपल बाय द एंड ऑफ जुलाई 2021. सो हुम सो एवर इज वर्किंग विद इंडियन रेलवे, इधर इट इज अ कॉन्ट्रैक्टर और रेगुलर एम्प्लॉयज ऑन द ट्रेन, ईच ऑफ देम शुड बी वैक्सीनेटेड बाय जुलाई एंड. Now reward is also there for the officer who are doing well. So the Ministry of Railway said that they have decided to suitably reward the divisional and zonal head for the best practices, right? Vaccinations or jo reducing vaccine wastage should be the target. And similarly, the scheme would also initiate the staff remaining motivated to face the challenges, right? So we need to create a workforce, and that workforce should be properly vaccinated, and this should cater the requirement, the need of the citizen of this country. Now the other news from Indian Express, proposed Limuru Elephant Reserve in Chhattisgarh. This is important for the General Studies Paper 3, Conservation, Environmental Pollution and EIA. Also, this news is very relevant for your prelims examination considering the map work. So do check it out, where do you find the Limuru Elephant Reserve. So what is there? Basically, Limuru Elephant Reserve jo isko proposed ki gayi thi 20 years down, 2 decades back. But still, this is a controversial subject which has not been executed yet. एक लेटर उन्होंने रिलीज किया था स्टेट फॉरेस्ट डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ छत्तीसगढ़. दे हैव सेड जो उनके प्रिंसिपल चीफ कंजर्वेटर है उनका कहना है कि द नंबर इज गोइंग टू डिक्रीज. जो प्रपोज्ड रिजर्व फॉरेस्ट थी उसमें इनिशियली 1995 स्क्वायर किलोमीटर की एरिया प्रपोज की गई थी. नाउ दे हैव डिक्रीज द एरिया टू 450 स्क्वायर किलोमीटर. वाई दे हैव डन सो वील अंडरस्टैंड दैट एज वेल. So first, let's understand what is Limuru Elephant Reserve. Agar baat kare, this is there in the Korba district of Chhattisgarh. This is one of the most effective district of Chhattisgarh by the militant, or you can say the Maoist. So Korba in Chhattisgarh and other districts like Dantewada, these are the most affected areas. And assembly mein basically 2005 mein ye proposed ki gayi thi, and it was approved by the central government in 2007. So Limuru is one of the two elephant reserve that was planned to prevent human animal conflict. Usse bachne ke liye is tarah ki cheezon ko plan ki gayi thi. And now elephant moving into Chhattisgarh from Odisha coming from to Jharkhand also. And it is an area when was proposed for 50 kilometers, right? So now let's see what is the main rationale why government reduced the size of this reserve. बेसिकली जब इनिशियली अनाउंस की गई थी तो 1990 के लिए अनाउंस की गई थी. वाई इट हैज़ रिड्यूस टू फोर, आई मीन द नंबर हैज़ रिड्यूस टू 450 किलोमीटर्स. सो द एरिया प्रपोज्ड अंडर द रिजर्व इज अ पार्ट ऑफ हैसडेलो अन्य फॉरेस्ट, और एक डाइवर्स बायोजोन फॉरेस्ट है जहाँ पे जो कोयले की अगर बात करें रिजर्व वो काफ़ी हाई है. सो दे आर रिच इन द कोल डिपॉजिट्स एंड रिजर्व, एंड 22 कोल ब्लॉक्स आर देयर इन द एरियाज, राइट. And the processes of being established in the four. Agar baat kare under no-go area, the entire area was considered to be bound by the mines, and 5 coal block were the region to put on auctions. So one thing is clear, private players and private companies would definitely look forward that unke paas area jada ho, kyunki they would explore more and they would earn more. So kahin na kahin is decision se kuch private players ko bhi benefit milenge. I will show you a map that will help you understand. सी ये है प्रपोज्ड Limuru Elephant Reserve, और आप देख सकते हो दिस इज अ बफर जोन, दीज आर द कोल ब्लॉक्स, राइट. एक्चुअली दिस वॉज प्रपोज्ड दिस मच, और यहाँ पे अडानी की पी के बे माइन है. सो दे डेफिनेटली वॉन्ट दे शुड कम इन साइड एंड माइन एज मच एज दे कैन, राइट. सो दिस इज अ रीजन इसके जो एरियाज हैं 9990 से घटा करके 450 किलोमीटर्स कर दी गई है. Now in 2008 what has happened that the CII, Confederation of Industries, उन्होंने letter लिखी government को, and they have requested that at least the reserve should be made to 40 million ton of the coal accessible. And government has said कि decision because villagers ने कहा है कि उनके representation खरकस के जो MLAs हैं, they said the people want that coal mine should be there. But this is not the exact case, you know, we will not getting into the detail of that other part, the political benefit that the people is not actually looking for, but they quoted ki public representations of villagers ne kaha ki wahan pe mines liye exploration honi chahiye. However, several villagers have already given their consent for the acquisitions of land. So this is another debatable issue. For you it is important ki jo Limuru Elephant Reserve hai uske bare mein aap dekh le. Prelims point of view se map work mein kafi zyada important hai. Now, what is the importance of reserve in Chhattisgarh? So elephant ki baat kare, elephant are found in 5 division on the state. Pehla agar north Chhattisgarh mein dekhe to 240 elephants paayi jaati hai. Uske baad 150 elephants died in the state over the last 20 years, including 16 between June to October 2020. So again, these numbers are decreasing drastically, and government should take some conclusive action so that we could have a good number of elephant in the particular area. And elephants in Chhattisgarh are relatively new according to the expert. And they have basically, jab Madhya Pradesh alag hue the 1990 mein, so many of the elephant has moved to the Chhattisgarh region. And since these animals were relatively new, animal jo human conflict ko kam karne ke liye, they are straying into the inhabited area and they are looking for a food, right? So these are some of the main reason why the reserve is moving from Madhya Pradesh to Chhattisgarh. Now the other news, this is an editorial from the Hindu. The title is Tapping on the Potential of the Youth. This is important for your general studies paper 2, Government Policies and Intervention for the Development of Various Sectors. So what is the detail of this news? What are the issues under this editorial? So I have segregated this into 5 important topics. That is, first, India demographic dividend. Kya kya challenges hai? Impact of pandemic. Impact of pandemic on adolescents or way forward kya honi chahiye. Puri editorial ki theme ki baat kare, is editorial mein baat ki gayi hai kis tarah se jo demographic dividend hai usko harness karne ki zarurat hai, and specifically for the female, right? How we can harness it. So let's understand the detail of this news, what it talks about. World Population Day, as we know, it's celebrated on July 11th. Usme focus rakhi gayi hai on the importance of population related issues, right? So the first World Population Day was observed by the United Nations in 1989. और जो पूरा aim था is to discourse the sustainable way on safeguarding each life and adding up the population, right? That is sustainable for the environment as well and as well for the region. But reports के मुताबिक अगर देखें UNDP और Lancet की report, India would stabilize its population by 12 years earlier than accepted. So let understand that India has a huge potential in terms of its demography. And India ki jo demographic dividend hai, usme 253 million aise log hai, they are the age group of adolescents population. Adolescents is a age group between 11 to 17, right? So this age group has a huge potential. Par agar baat kare, over 62% of the people are aged between 50 to 59. So this is a potential of India. Aur uske baad jo median age hai, is less than 30 years, right? So definitely India has its on a higher side. Demographic potentials jo hai, jo demographic dividend hai, wo kisi aur country ke apeksha India mein kafi high hai. Now these demographic dividend need to harness, inki jo potential hai usko hume economic growth milane ki zarurat hai, and jo age structure population, that has to be streamlined through government policy and skilling, right? So skilling is again very important. However, inke transforming ki agar baat kare is potential ki, that require adolescents and youth to be healthy as well as educated. So until and unless our youth are healthy and educated, they cannot contribute in the nation development. Kuch challenges ki baat ki gayi hai COVID ke time mein. Schools jis tarah se na, specifically talking about educations. So in education, what has happened? That the school has been closed due to the COVID-19, right? So bahut aise under funded educational institutions थे जिनको बंद कर दिया गया. And according to the World Bank, public expenditure जो है इंडिया में educational institutions पे, that is only 4.4% of the GDP in 2019, और इस अभी भी इस बार के बजट में 3.4% ही रखी गई है. So the report revealed कि इंडिया के जो stand है वो 62 है in terms of public expenditure per student, right? ये fairly is quality education measures की बात करें, student teacher ratio is again very less. So these are some of the challenges that government need to focuses upon to harness our potential demographic dividend. Now impact of pandemic, agar baat kare, 32 crore students aise the jinko lockdown ki wajah se formal education mein kafi problem hui, they have discontinued. And in this 32 crore, 15.8 crore were females. So you can see almost half the number is of the female, right? And the number of school girls have impacted, 158 million ऐसे लोग हैं, they have been dropped from the school, they are not going to school, and the school remained closed even in the remote area where the effect of pandemic has been minimal. तो पूरे स्टेट में, बाद में जब स्टेट गवर्नमेंट में रेगुलेट किया कोविड मैनेजमेंट को, हर स्टेट ने अपने अपने डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट एक्ट लगाए, तो जो रिमोट एरिया के स्कूल्स थे उनको भी बंद कर दिया गया. सो दिस हैज सीवियरली इम्पैक्टेड द ओवरऑल एजुकेशन एंड क्वालिटी. एंड ऑल दो आई पर्सनली फील कुछ ऐसे डिसीजन ज़रूरी भी थे टू कंट्रोल द कोविड, राइट? So student shows that the closure of the school have seriously impacted their life and mental well-being. Now this is a time, once the situation is under control, we have to unlock it and we have to see how we can improve the overall quality of the education in the interior as well as in the mainstream part of the states. Now, impact of pandemic on adolescents, kya kya adolescents pe inki impact hui hai. So ek survey ki gayi thi by International Label Organization, they have revealed that 65% of the adolescents worldwide are reported to have learned less during the pandemic, right? Why? Because of the bottlenecks, the digital divide which is there. Many people do not have access to cell phone, smartphone, and even the internet connectivity. So, is wajah se jo learning process hai, wo kafi slow rahi. 51% of them felt learning would be further delayed, right? And it has also highlighted ki jo adolescents hai, unki mental well-being is taken a big ball. Or 17% of the young people are likely to suffer from anxiety and depression. So these are some astonishing survey coming from the International Labour Organization. Now, what would be the way forward? How we can overcome this problem? What is the right strategy to ensure that our potential demographic dividend is correctly harnessed? So first, therefore, a policy need to balance the risk of transmission through child and arm the prolonged school closures. So, jitne schools bande hain, unko open karke, वापस से एक मेन स्ट्रीम में लाने की ज़रूरत है. एंड इट इज़ इम्परेटिव मैकेनिज्म फॉर बेटर स्कूल कॉरपोरेशन, यहाँ पे सेफगार्ड भी हो बच्चों के लिए. और एक कोऑर्डिनेशन बनाए, कोऑर्डिनेशन डिपार्टमेंट बनाने की ज़रूरत है. दैट शुड प्रोवाइड एफिशिएंसी क्राइसिस अगेंस्ट द एडोलेसेंस फेजेस. उसके साथ साथ जो मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हेल्थ है, हेल्थ एंड फैमिली अफेयर, मस्ट कोलाबरेट विद द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एजुकेशन टू डिसमिनेट द की इन्फॉर्मेशन टू हेल्प एडोलेसेंस सेफगार्ड्स एंड हेल्दी एंड एबिलिटी टू लर्न, राइट. Also, at this point of time, many other educations like personality development, how to cope up with mental stress, these type of modules should also be given to the adolescent child so that they can have positive sentiments towards life and they should be filled positively to move ahead in their life, right? So these are some of the psychological mechanism that can government impart in the school curriculums. Now moving ahead with the MCQ's question of the day, before I proceed with the questions, just to tell you the answers of yesterday question, that is the Saturday. So for both the question, the correct option here is C, right? Do check it out what you have marked. Now today's question, consider the following statement regarding the inflation. Inflation measures the average price change of the basket commodities and services over time. Inflation is indicative to decrease the purchasing power of unit in the country currency. So if you know, if you have studied economics with NCERT, this would be a cakewalk for you and you can easily answer these questions. So do write your answer in the comment section. Second question, consider the following statement about Great Indian Bustard. The Great Indian Bustard is one of the heaviest flying birds in the world and it happens to be the state bird of Madhya Pradesh. So if you know the correct answer, let me know in the comment section down below. So participate more and more and write your answer in the comment section. So this was all about the daily news and editorial analysis followed by the MCQ's question. If you have any other concern, do let me know. I'll be more than happy to assist you. For time being, I'm signing off. Wish you all the best. Thank you so much for listening.